guys, my name is Landon, and today I am bringing you guys another video here today talking a little bit about roster mania, some post-UMG Dallas, roster changes have happened, some swaps have gone down, teams like Elevate, Rise, and even Enigma 6 has lost half their team, so we got a lot of stuff to talk about, some things to mention, who could be switching teams, and maybe, when all this is going to stop, and when it's going to be even, worse or more. It's kind of hard to talk about roster mania. It's like, oh, when all the good stuff happens, but in, like, retrospect, if you look at it, it's kind of like negative in some ways, but regardless, we're going to want to talk about some of the roster changes that have happened, some of the stuff that could happen, and a lot of stuff that is to come. Alright, so the first thing that we actually have with roster mania has to do with Enigma 6. Obviously, we know new roster, new team, first event as a whole squad together would have been at UMG Dallas. Obviously, that happened last weekend, and they didn't do very well, to say the least. They ended up finishing 0-4 in their pool, made it a little bit through a loser's bracket run. If you guys didn't know, the top two teams from each pool, there was actually five teams. After each open bracket team made it through, and there would actually be so five teams in each pool. They ended up finishing at the very bottom, going 0-4, so losing to every single team they played, which is really, really bad. And they made it a couple, they beat a couple teams in the losers bracket, but ended up getting it knocked out very early on. So that roster not looking good. That team was, I guess you could say, consisting of Parasite, Proofy, General, and Imruiz. Obviously, General and Imruiz used to be the previous two on Enigma 6. They also had Cade and Exib, who now are on Tactical Turtles, I believe. Just want to say, Tactical Turtles, probably the best name I've ever heard. I'm not going to lie. Like, I genuinely support them, and I have no idea who they are. Like, I've never heard of that organization, but I want to be a part of it. So I want to say, this was like maybe Monday morning. Enigma 6 basically announced that Parasite has officially left the team. He will no longer be on Enigma 6. He has a better opportunity, and we'll talk about what happens with that in just a little bit. So Parasite no longer on the team. Not really a surprise. Arguably, to me, coming into this tournament, is one of the best teams that we have who aren't in the league. You look at some other teams, you look at, like XGN or VVV, teams that aren't in necessarily the pro league, but are also not too bad either. You know, they're a very, very talented team. They have, Proofy, who's a veteran. Obviously, you also have Parasite. General, a great young player as well. So this team was looking pretty good for me. I was like, I'm not sure how they're going to do, but online, they've been looking pretty well. Now with Parasite gone, it's just like, they went from somewhere pretty high, and I was like, maybe this team could last together. Parasite seems very happy with the team that he's on, and I was like, this might last a little bit. I even saw Parasite a little bit. Didn't get a chance to talk to him, but he seemed pretty happy. He was constantly hanging out with General. I saw Imruiz rocking around a little bit. I didn't see too much of Proofy, but still, those guys were just hanging out, and it seemed like they were having a strong bond, and that's a team, and that's a characteristic you want to have with any given team that you're on. I never had the pleasure of casting over Enigma 6, but they didn't really make it far enough for me to actually have the opportunity to do so. So, kind of unfortunate for Enigma 6. Later on, they announced that they will be dropping Imruiz. They also said he left. From what I've heard and from what I've been told, Parasite left, Imruiz is dropped. That's basically how it works. Imruiz even said that on Twitter. So, Imruiz didn't have a very good event. Looking at their KDs, General had a 0.90 KD, Imruiz had a 0.8, Parasite had a 1.02, and Proofy had a 0.94. But kind of unfortunate for him to be dropped, especially since he joined back with the team, but still, that is unfortunate. Later on, I believe Tactical Turtles announced that they will be picking up Imruiz, so that team is now consisting of the three regular E6 players, but General still on E6, so that roster of Tactical Turtles, I know for sure, is Cade, Exib, and Imruiz. So, they don't have General. Obviously, General's probably not going to leave our Tactical Turtles, at least as far as we know, but Proofy, and I saw General still tuning out for team scrims, are still looking for two. So for right now, that roster is currently just sitting at General and Proofy. And to finish off the talk about Enigma 6, they actually posted on Twitter, which, no offense, I like Enigma 6, don't get me wrong, but still, they cannot post this stuff on Twitter. It's just frustrating. So basically what they put it on Twitter, they said that Parasite has left our team and he will be going to Isolation Empire, which is true and it's also not true. They made it sound like he is their new fourth. He's only going to be a sub for right now. From what I've heard and from what I've seen on Twitter, Llama God posted and he said, I'm not going to be able to compete for like the next month. I'm going to be out of the country on what? I have no idea, but Parasite will be filling in for Enigma 6 for that period of time. A lot of people were asking me why can't God or X fill in. It's because he's actually banned on MLG. He actually posted a tweet longer, which I actually read, and I already knew the information, but long story short, he did something he shouldn't have, and he is no longer allowed to be in the MLG Pro League or compete at MLG events. So that's why they're not using God or X. Parasite now, they're filling. As far as we know, he's not their official fourth. Will that happen? I don't know. I think they're going to kind of test him out, see how he works with the squad, and if he works pretty well, they might, you know, have him as a regular fourth, and, you know, if maybe that it doesn't work out, they might just drop him. I think that's how it's going to work. As far as I know, he's going to be a sub for the team. We'll see what happens later on. And I also saw a silly tweet out that they're picking up someone named Jordy. I've never heard of him, but that's also maybe a player that they're going to use. I have no idea what's going on with ISO. I don't even think they know for sure, but that's also someone that could be playing for sure. Parasite might just be only a sub. I really don't know. So that's kind of how it stands. So some of the next bit of info we have is actually coming from 3ZUP Enterprises. I actually saw Hilton, the owner of 3ZUP at UMG Dallas, talk to him just a little bit while we were going on the elevator a little bit, asking about his team, and he didn't seem very happy with him. But off of that, it looks like they actually picked up a new player. They said, "Give a warm welcome to our new COD player at Miyagi_3ZUP. Roster right now consists of Khalifa, Strife, Miyagi, and that's it for right now." So that roster, obviously, that's, I believe, the original 3ZUP team. That could be wrong. I know that they have at least played together, Miyagi, Strife, and Khalifa. So I'm glad to see those guys back together, I guess. Miyagi's a great player. I believe he's been playing a lot of CSGO, as far as I know. But, 3ZUP picked up a really good guy there. To be honest, Strife's not my favorite. He doesn't have the best KD. He's not, like, the guy I really go off. But Khalifa's a really good guy, to have on the roster, as well as Miyagi. So that roster is currently looking for one, as far as we know. But with that roster, it is Strife, Khalifa, and Miyagi. So that's what they're rolling with right now. Looking to see who they can pick up, possibly, in the future. Now for the really big news. This one is currently consisting, it's not like major, but it involves two league teams. So this is kind of, interesting. So we got a new Elevate roster and a new Rise roster. What happened was there was two teams that really switched, and this is what came out first. Elevate tweeted out, "We have officially decided to part ways with Elevate Apathy and welcome back TJ Halley to the Elevate COD team." I didn't expect this at all, actually. I thought that, Elevate had a very good run. I believe they finished 12-0 in their pool, but did not make it far after that, which is kind of, sad for Elevate. I believe their problem was just not having the dominant AR. TJ Halley doesn't really fix that role, to be honest. Like, I know he can kind of switch between guns and stuff, but I thought Apathy played pretty well. I think he had one of the highest KDs for their team. So the new Elevate roster will be consisting of Classic, Slacked, obviously now they have TJ Halley and Saints. So that's going to be the new Elevate roster. But just after this all went down, Ryze announced that their newest pickup will be Ryze Apathy. So Apathy coming back to Ryze, well, not coming back, but joining Ryze, kind of like a switch in a sense. They didn't actually trade, but it was kind of like, we're going to drop this guy, so we'll pick this guy up. We'll pick up the guy that you dropped because we dropped our guy. Yeah, that makes sense. Now, this is pretty interesting. I wasn't really sure what was going to happen with Apathy. I was like, he might get picked up probably by Ryze. I kind of assumed that, but I wasn't really for sure. So that roster now will be Chino, Wheats, Apathy, and TCM. Honestly, that's a good team, but it's not a team where I'm like, oh my gosh, that is a squad that is going to Ryze up through the Pro League. I believe right now Ryze is in the bottom, like they're in the bottom two teams, I believe, with Epsilon, who haven't won a game yet. But still, this team could improve. I think maybe Apathy being the leader for this squad might be what he needs. Maybe a little bit of change of pace where he doesn't have to take direction from someone, and instead he can kind of provide that direction. Being, I wouldn't say like a veteran in the scene, but he's been around for a little bit of time. Maybe could lead these guys to a better placing in the Pro League, and overall could help himself out. So I'm not sure with the new Ryze roster. I'm not really sure about the Elevate team. Honestly, I feel like Apathy is a little bit better than TJ Halley. I think that's kind of up for speculation. People could say, well, no, TJ Halley is better at this, but Apathy's a more dominant slayer. Apathy's been very inconsistent, but also, you've seen TJ Halley not perform the best at times either. So we'll have to see what happens. Who won the trade could be, a hashtag that might go around. I'm not really sure. Looking at both of these rosters, Chino, Wheats, TCM, and Apathy, it's not my favorite team by any stretch of the imagination. I'm not sure if we'll see Ryze make any more changes. To be honest, I would like them to. This isn't a very good team, in my opinion. Just looking at the three players that Elevate still have, that's a very dominant squad. So I'm going to say that Elevate still has the better roster, but we'll see what happens. Apathy, a great player, as well as TJ Halley is also. So we'll have to see. But that is the major part of Roster Mini thus far. So we also have a little bit of players tweeting out that they are going to need teams. And this isn't like on the record for sure, but these are a couple things that we saw, I saw. Felony tweeted out, "So me, Fierce, and Fizz most likely need one for MES and DC. He also put LOL, so I'm not sure if that's a joke or if John's not really going to be on the team anymore. Obviously, that is the entire VVV team besides John, so we'll have to see what happens, but still, looks like who would they pick up? I really have no idea, to be honest. We'll have to see what goes on with VVV. VVV looked pretty good. Felony didn't have the best KD, but whenever I saw him, he really went off. And to be honest, John was not a factor at all whenever I casted over them. Watching them versus XGN, he wasn't really there. They did 3-0 XGN, it just wasn't they just didn't look like the VVV that I thought they would be. You know, John is a main slayer. He's one of the best players at it whenever he's on, I admit. But still, did not have the best event. Also, looking at Spacely's Twitter for this event, he was on XGN. And he also tweeted, free agent looking for two with study COD, DM, or text me to make moves. So the XGN team was consisting of Killa, Goonjar, Study, and obviously Spacely. This team was definitely put together for this event. You know, UMG Dallas, they obviously, I feel there's like a pool of players who are just constantly teaming with each other, looking for squads to play with, and I feel like, you know, Spacely and Study and Killa have really been in that pool of players, and also now Goonjar, who was on TK, on Rise, and now he's been dropped, so we'll see what happens with that squad. For right now, I'm assuming Killa and Goonjar are still on XGM. I really have no idea, I haven't seen them tweet out, but still, looks like Spacely and Study looking for a team of two. Could they join E6? I have no idea. We'll have to see what happens, but that wouldn't be the move that I would personally try to make, but still, that is just about it for Roster Mania this far. Oh, one last thing really quick, I apologize. Elevate also announced on Twitter, they said, due to Gfinity rules, this will be our roster for the Gfinity event, which will be Select, Classic, Replays, and Denial Slasher. Obviously, Replays and Slasher, both on Denial. They have Hook and Temp, who aren't old enough to go to this event, and Select and Classic also have Saints, who can't travel out of the United States, I believe. I don't think he can leave for some reason. I'm not really sure, but we won't go into that. And also, they have TJ Halley. So, it looks like Elevate and Denial combining for Gfinity, so that's going to be their roster. That's a pretty good team. It's not my favorite, but it's not too bad, you know, either. I think that's a pretty good lineup, and that's actually going to be it for Roster Mania this far. I wanted to just give you guys a little bit of an update. I know it's been kind of fuzzy. If you haven't really been on Twitter, you would have no idea what's going on, just because it's been kind of behind closed doors. I haven't really seen the ESR mention it a whole lot, so that's just about it. So hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. If you guys did, make sure to leave a like, and I will be doing updates like this throughout the entire, you know, role of Roster Mania from here on till Black Ops 9. So we'll have to see that. But guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to leave a like, and I'll be posting a lot more videos. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys later, and peace out. That was weird. Peace out.